Hello dear students, how are you? So today we would move ahead in this chapter of mathematics, that is playing in numbers, chapter number 2. So here I have some new questions. In the previous video I told you about the prime numbers, composite numbers, twin primes, co-primes, all these things we have discussed in the previous video. So now here I have some questions here for you. Like the first one is, write all prime numbers between number 1 10 and 50, number 2 70 and 90, and 3 40 and 85, and the fourth one is 60 and 100. You have to write all the prime numbers between the given numbers. Let's say the first one is, answer of the first one I can write here, rest you have to do on your own. So first one I'm writing, we have to write all the prime numbers between 10 and 50. What are the prime numbers? Prime numbers, numbers which have only two factors, means the number itself and one. Okay, so you have to write all the prime numbers between 10 and 50. So what could be the numbers? Like first after 10, what comes after 10? 11. So 11 is prime. Yes, it is prime. So answer is 11. Then after 11 comes 12. 12 is not prime. 13. Yes, 13 is prime. Then comes 17. Then 19. Then comes 23. Then comes 29. Then comes 31. Okay. Then comes 37 also, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41 also, 42, 43 also, 44, 45, 46, 47, yeah, 47 also, 48, 49, 50, now up to 50, these are all the numbers. So between 10 and 50, these are the prime numbers here, okay? 11, 13, 17, 19, 23, 29, 31, 37, 41, 43 and 47. So these are the prime numbers between 10 and 50. Similarly, you have to write this answer of the second question. You have to write the prime numbers between 70 and 90. Write it on your own. Means the number which have only two factors, which are not divisible by any number, which are divisible by itself. Remember this. The numbers which are divisible by itself are known as prime number. Like here, 11. 11 is divisible by 11 only. Like you say 41. 41 is divisible by 41 only. So that is why these all are the prime numbers. So similarly, you have to write the prime numbers between 70 and 90 also. Okay. Then this and then this. Rest of the question you have to do on your own. Second question. What is the smallest prime number? Is it an even number? So you just tell me, what would be the smallest prime number? Is it 1? Yeah. 1 cannot be a prime number, because to be a prime number, we need the two factors. That is 1 and the number itself. We need two factors. Means the number should be divisible by two digits. The numbers should be divisible by two numbers. Okay. Like say, suppose I am writing here 5. So 5 is a prime number, because 5 is divisible by 1. 1 5 is a 5. As well as this 5 is divisible by 5 also. Are you getting this? So that is why 5 is a prime number. Okay. So we have to write, what would be the smallest prime number? Can you tell me? 1? No, 1 is not a smallest prime number. 2? Yes. 2, if you see the factors of means 2 is divisible by 1 as well as it is divisible by 2. So means 2 is the smallest prime number. So answer of the first question, what is the smallest prime number? Answer is 2. Answer is what? Answer is 2 is the smallest prime number. Are you getting this? 2 is the smallest prime number. Now next is it an even number? Is this 2 an even number? Yes, this 2 is an even number. Okay. And next part of the question is, yes, 2 is an even number. What does this mean? It implies that 2 is even prime number also. Okay. 2 is the only number which is even as well as prime. Rest of the even numbers are not prime numbers. Only 2 is the even number which is a prime number also. Okay. Next question. Question is, which of the following pairs are always co-prime? Co-prime numbers means? Co-prime numbers means? What are co-prime numbers? Means the numbers which do not have any common factor other than 1. Let's say I am writing two number. Let's say I am writing the number 4 and 9. So 4 and 9 are co-prime numbers. Why these are co-prime numbers? Because the factors, if you see the factors of 4 are 1, 2 and 4. If you see the factors of 9, factors of 9 are 1, 3 and 9. So what are the common factor here? common factor is one here also. So only one is the common factor. If one is the common factor between these two given numbers, then you would call such numbers as co-prime numbers. So 4 and 9 are co-prime numbers. Okay. So here you have to tell which of the following pairs are co-prime here. Now you tell me, twin prime numbers are co-prime numbers? Yes. Any twin numbers you take, because you are knowing about the twin numbers. What are twin numbers? Twin numbers are those, twin numbers are those which both of the twin numbers should be prime number, and between them there should be a composite number also. Okay, we call them as the twin primes. Like suppose you take the example of 3 and 5. These are both, 3 is prime number, 5 is also prime number, and between 3 and 4 what comes? That is 4, and 4 is a composite number. Okay, the number between two given numbers should be a composite number, and the number, both the numbers should be prime numbers. So you will call such numbers as twin prime. So 3 and 5 are twin primes also. Okay, so 3 and 5 are twin prime. So tell me whether this 3, 5 are co-prime also. Yes, if you see the factors of 3 are 1, 3 factors of 5 are 1, 5, so common factor is 1 here. So you would call these numbers as co-prime also. It implies what? It implies all the twin primes are co-prime also. Any twin prime number you take, you would find them as co-prime also. Any twin prime. Let's say I am taking another example here of twin primes. Let's say it is 5 and 7. 5 and 7 both are prime numbers, and between them there is 6. 6 is a composite number because it is having more than 2 factors. So 5 and 7 are prime, and between them 6 is the number which is composite number. It implies what? It implies 5 and 7 are twin primes. Now you tell me whether 5 and 7 are co-prime also. If you see the factors of 5 are 1 and 5. Factors of 7 are 1 or 7. So common factor is 1 here. So you would call 5 and 7 are co-prime number also. Okay. So we have a conclusion here, and that all the twin primes, any twin prime number you take, all are co-prime number also. Okay. So all twin primes are co-primes. Okay. This is the conclusion we are getting out of here. Okay. So here you write, all twin primes are co-primes. All twin primes are co-primes. So this is the conclusion we are getting here. Okay. All twin primes are co-primes. So we have a conclusion here, and that is all twin primes are co-primes. Okay. So any twin prime numbers you take, all the twin primes are co-prime number. Okay. Second question, one prime number and one composite number. We have to make a set of one prime and one composite number. Then we have to tell whether these set is a set of co-prime. Okay, which of the following pair are always co-prime, that you have to tell. Na? So here we have a pair here. Pair of one prime number and another composite number. Let's take 3 prime number, and another number we have to take the composite number. Let's say it is 6. Okay. Now here one is prime number, another one is the composite number. Now we have to tell whether these are co-prime also or not. Let's check. Factor of 3 are 1, 3. Factors of 6 are 1, 3, 2, 6. These are the factors of 6. Now what are the common factor between these two? Common factor is 1 also, as well as 3 also. So we have 1 also common factor, and 3 also as the common factor. So it implies what? It implies 3 and 6 are not a set of co-prime here. Okay. So question was, one prime and one composite number should be prime number? No, not always. Yeah, in some case it might happen in some case. Yeah, it could happen in some case also, that one prime number and one composite number you are taking, and they are coming out to be as co-prime also. Like suppose I am taking an example here. Suppose one prime number I am taking as 5, another composite number I am taking as 9. So 5 and 9. Here 5 is a prime number, 9 is a composite number. If you see the factors of 5, 1, 5. If it is the factors of 9, 1, 3, 9. So you see the common factor between these two. So what are the common factors here? Only one is the common factor. So you would call these numbers as co-prime. So if you are taking one prime and one composite number, sometime you are getting a set of co-prime, but sometime you are not getting, here you are not getting a set of co-prime, but here you are getting a set of co-prime. So it cannot happen always. Okay. It cannot happen always, but in some cases it might happen that yes, you are getting a set of co-prime. Okay. So here the answer would be not always, not always means always we are not getting. Okay, example 3 and 6, not prime, are not prime here. And if you take the set of 5 and 9, these are prime. These are set of prime numbers. So in some case you would get the prime number, co-prime. Co-prime. Okay. In some case you would get prime, co-prime, and in some case you would not get co-prime. Okay. So both ways it happens. So then you would say at not always. Okay. Next is two composite numbers. So whether you tell me whether two composite numbers can be prime numbers also? Yes, it can be, but cannot also. Like suppose I am taking two examples. I am giving you two examples. Like suppose two composite numbers. One I am taking 4, other I am taking 8. Both are composite number, because factors of 4 are also more than 2 factor. 1, 2, 4, and factors of 8 are also more than 2 factor. So you would call 4 and 8 as the composite number. So 2 composite number here I am taking. Let me take one more set, that is, let's say it is 4 and 9. Here also both are composite number. 4 also composite number and 9 also composite number. Now if you see the factors of 4 and 8, what are the factors of 4? Factors of 4 are 1, 2, 4. And factors of 8 are 1, 2, 4, 8. And what are the common factor between these two? Between those two, we have common factor 1 also, 2 also, 4 also. So these are not prime. Are not prime. Are not co-prime. These are not co-prime. Okay. If you are taking two composite number and you are thinking whether these are prime or not, these are co-prime or not. So these are not co-prime because you have more than two common factors here. Sorry. We have a common factor here other than 1 also. Okay. Are you getting this? Yes. If you take the next case, here 4 and 9, both are composite number. Now if you see the factors of 4, what are the factors of 1, 2, comma 4? These are the factors of 4. If you see the factors of 9, these are 1, 3, comma 9. Now if you see the common factor between these two, so only 1 is the common factor. Now you would call these numbers as co-prime because they have only 1 as the common factor. So in some cases, it can happen that yes, if you are taking two composite number, you are getting co-prime. But in some cases, it may not happen also, like in this case. We are taking two composite numbers and these are not co-prime numbers. Okay. So here it says are co-primes. Are co-primes. Okay. So answer of the question, two composite numbers are prime co-prime numbers. So answer it, not always also. Hence, not always. Means always we are not getting set of co-prime. Yeah, in some cases, we are getting co-prime, but in some cases we cannot. Okay, are you getting this? Note these questions down then. Now you see here I have some new questions. Express the following as the sum of two or more prime numbers. We have to express this 13 in terms of the sum of two or more than two prime numbers. Okay, so if you want to express this 11 as the sum of two and more than two prime, so I can write this this 13 as 11 plus 2 here. 11 plus 2, both are prime number, and if you are adding these two, you are getting 13 out of that. Are you getting? You can write 3 numbers also, you can write 4 numbers also, but all should be prime number. Okay, all should be prime number. Okay, are you getting this? Like suppose we have another example, that is 130. So express this in terms of sum of two prime numbers or more than two primes. Let's say express this 130 now. So I can write this 130 as 59 plus 71. If you see, both are prime number also. If you are adding these two, you are getting 130. Similarly, 180, we can express this 180 as the sum of two or more than two. In terms of more than two, we are just doing this 180. If you see, this 80, we can get this 180. By adding, let's say we are adding 13, start from the 11. Let's say we are adding 11, then we are adding 13, 3, 4. Then we are adding 17 here. Then we are adding 139. Now, if you see, all these are prime numbers. And if you are adding all these two, you would get how much? you would get 180. Are you getting this? This is 17. Okay, so we have expressed this 180 also in terms of more than two prime numbers. You can express it in terms of two also. If you are adding like 79 and 101, 79 and 101, we are getting 180. Here also both are prime number also. So we can express it in terms of two also and more than two also. This is the question. Express in terms of two or more than two. This is the answer. Okay. Now in the second question, express the following as the sum of two odd primes. Two odd primes means both the numbers should be prime and odd also. And you are knowing about there is only one even prime number, that is 2. Means here you cannot take 2. Like here we have taken 2 because here in the question there was not given there. We have to express in terms of odd primes. It was not written. Only in terms of prime number we have to express. But here it has been written here. Okay. Express the following as the sum of 2 primes. Odd primes you have to take. Means you cannot add here 2 now. You would not take 2 as the prime number here. Okay. So now express 30 as the sum of 2 odd. Here only 2 numbers you have to take now. Remember this. So 36 can be written as 31 plus how much? 5. Yes. 31 plus 5. Both 31 is also prime. 5 is also prime. Both are odd primes. So when you are adding things, you are getting 36. Similarly, you would express 84 also on your own. Okay. Next question is, express the following as the sum of 3 odd primes. Here you take 3 prime number, all should be odd. Means here also you cannot take 2. You cannot take 2. Right? Here we have taken 2. 11 plus 2. So here we can take 2. But in this and in these two questions, we cannot take 2 because we had to express it in terms of 2 odd primes. Are you getting this? So similarly, just express this 31 as the sum of 3 odd primes. So what I am telling, rest you will do on your own here. So like say, suppose if you want to express 13, so I can write it as 11 plus 13. How much? Plus 7. Look here. 11 plus 13 plus 7. So add these 3, you would get 31. And all are prime and odd primes here. In terms of 3 odd primes, you have to express. Similarly, express the 35 also as well as 41 also. Are you getting this? Just note this question down. Then you would be doing the last question of today. Now, this is the last question here. Question is, express the following as the sum of twin primes. Here you have to take twin prime numbers. Both should be twin prime numbers. And by adding these two twin prime numbers, you would get 36. Okay. So, question is 36. How do you get 36? By adding two twin primes. Let's say if I am taking two twin primes as 17 and 19. 17 and 19 and twin primes. Why? Because between 17 and 19, there is a number that is 18, and 18 is a composite number because it is having more than two factors. Okay. So you would call 17 and 19 as twin primes. Both are prime. 17 is also a prime number. 19 is also a prime number. And in between 17 and 19, you have 18, which is a composite number. So you would call 17 and 19 as twin primes. And if you are adding these two twin primes, you are getting 36. Okay. Similarly, express this 84 also as well as 120 also. So let me answer this. 84 can be expressed as the sum of 41 plus 43. 41 is a prime number. 43 is a prime number. In between these two, you are getting 42. 42 is a complex number. Sorry, composite number. Are you getting this? So hence these numbers are twin primes. And if you are adding these two, you are getting 84. Okay. Similarly, express this 120 also. How do you express this 120 as the sum of two twin primes? If you are adding, try it yourself first. Okay, take some time, pause the video. Just try to do it yourself. Okay, if not possible, then look here again. Okay, 120 can be written as 59 plus 61. Are you getting this? If you see, 59 is a prime number. 61 is also a prime number. In between 59 and 61, you have 60, which is a composite number. It means these both are twin primes. And if you are adding these two twin primes, you are getting 120. So that's all for today. We'll be discussing some new questions in the upcoming videos. Till then, stay tuned and keep watching. Thank you. Have a good day.